In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome, everyone, as we come to celebrate this Mass on the 31st Sunday of Ordinary Time here at Our Lady of Las Vegas Church. We've entered a new month, the month of November, which traditionally in the Church is a time that we pray for the souls of the faithful departed. And so we offer this Mass. Since we have just celebrated All Saints' Day and All Souls' Day, we celebrate this Mass for the intention of all the souls in purgatory. Let us prepare to meet with Christ now as we acknowledge our sins and as we ask God for his mercy and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, by whose gift your faithful offer you right and praiseworthy service, grant, we pray, that we may hasten without stumbling to receive the things you have promised through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses spoke to the people, saying, "Fear the Lord your God, and keep throughout the days of your lives all his statutes and commandments, which I enjoin on you, and thus have long life. Hear then, Israel, and be careful to observe them, that you may grow and prosper the more, in keeping with the promise of the Lord, the God of your fathers, to give you a land flowing with milk and honey. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. Therefore you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul, and with all your strength. Take to heart these words which I enjoin on you today. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, the Levitical priests were many because they were prevented by death from remaining in office. But Jesus, because he remains forever, has a priesthood that does not pass away. Therefore, he is always able to save those who approach God through him, since he lives forever to make intercession for them. It was fitting that we should have such a high priest, holy, innocent, undefiled, separated from sinners, higher than the heavens. He has no need, as did the high priest, to offer sacrifice day after day for his own sins and then for those of the people. He did that once for all when he offered himself. For the law appoints men subject to weakness to be high priest, but the word of the oath, which was taken after the law, appoints a son who has been made perfect forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
One of the scribes came to Jesus and asked him, "Which is the first of all the commandments?" And Jesus replied, "This is the first. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is Lord alone. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: you shall love your neighbor as yourself." There is no other commandment greater than these. And the scribe said to him, Well said, teacher, you are right in saying, He is one, and there is no one other than he. And to love him with all your heart, with all your understanding, with all your strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself is worth more than all burnt offerings and sacrifices. And when Jesus saw that he understood, he said to him, You are not far from the kingdom of God. And no one dared to ask him any more questions. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There is one virtue without which human life cannot be imagined, a virtue that develops initiative, that pushes people to heroic deeds, is the engine of all human action, a virtue that unites people with each other. And this virtue is love. In today's gospel, when asked by a scribe what the greatest commandment is, Jesus answered that it is the commandment of love, love of God and of neighbor. Why? Because without this commandment, it is impossible to imagine human life, and the virtue of love is the foundation of the kingdom of heaven. But what is love, really? A difficult question. But Christ himself answered it, not so much with words, but with his whole life. Jesus said, Greater love has no one than he lay down his life for his friends. And Christ, out of love for us, gave us his life. God made man in his image and raised him above all creatures. And by sending us on a path of life, God endowed us with his most magnificent gift, his divine friendship, united in love. But man did not appreciate this gift, and through sin, this friendship was broken, and we walked away from God. But God did not walk away from man. He did not walk away from us. In his concern for our salvation and happiness, God promised to send a Redeemer. And when the promised Savior came, he testified with his teachings and most importantly with his life to God's love for us. In a conversation that Jesus had with Nicodemus, St. John the Evangelist writes what Jesus said, God so loved the world that he gave us his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Jesus showed us that God's love for us has no limits, and Jesus himself emphasized the everlasting value of love and taught this to his disciples. In his testament, his last testament during the Last Supper, Jesus told the apostles, As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Therefore, abide in my love. Jesus made this request on the evening of the day before he died. So Jesus consciously gave his life for the salvation of the whole world. He gave his life for each and every one of us. And as believers in Christ, it is our duty to believe in his love because love, again, is the foundation of the kingdom of heaven to which we are all called. Love has to be the banner of every Christian, of every person. St. Paul wrote, If I speak the language of men and of angels and know all the mysteries and have all knowledge and have faith that I can move mountains, but I do not have love, I am nothing. Nothing else matters. St. Paul ends this hymn to love with the words, Now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. And Jesus, after his resurrection, asked Peter, Do you love me more than these? Three times, Do you love me more than these? And Peter answers, Yes, Lord, you know that I love you. And if so, then feed my lambs, feed my sheep. Christ accepted Peter's confession of love and stated that that was most important for Peter to be his representative here on earth as the head of his church. So on Sunday, we come to church, we come to participate in Mass because it's a living renewal of Jesus' greatest act of love, his suffering, his death, his resurrection, all that he did out of love for us. And we also come for the purpose of knowing how great Christ's love is for us. So as children of the Father and as disciples of Jesus, we should want to ignite our hearts with the love that God has for us, return it to him, and share it with one another, as Jesus teaches us. So in prayer, let us always ask God to help us to love him and to love one another each day. Please join me now as we profess our faith together. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth.
Of all things visible and invisible, I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. For him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen.
Trusting that following God's commands of loving him and neighbor will set our feet on the road to the kingdom, we put into words now our needs and the needs of our neighbors.
For the church, that we may act collectively in great and small ways to express our love of God and love of neighbor, manifesting to the world how we put God's commands into action, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation's leaders and for all those running for office, that all elections may be peaceful and calm, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who struggle to love neighbor, family, or self, that they may be strengthened and formed in God's love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faith community, that they may continue to call upon God, their strength in times of joy, in times of turmoil, and in times of sorrow, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That more people follow God's call to dedicate their lives to expressing their love of God and love of neighbor through their service to others in the priesthood, diaconate, or religious life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick, for all who are in hospitals, nursing homes, and homebound, and for the intentions enrolled in our community book of prayer, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, that they may be brought into the eternal peace of God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the souls in purgatory and all our own personal intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. O God of universal love, you created us in your image. Help us to love in your image, as well as grant the prayers we make in love through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
I give you a new commandment that you
Please pray now, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good all of his holy church.
May these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, become for you a pure oblation, and for us a holy outpouring of your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know that it belongs to your boundless glory, Father, that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity. And you even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. So may our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we now acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and you are the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ's death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. And humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, George, Leo, Thomas, and Gregory Gordon, our bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all the souls in purgatory, and all who have died in your mercy. Father, welcome them into the light of your face, and have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you, Father, throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and that we may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And now, at our Savior's command, informed by his divine teaching, together let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
O Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Lord, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, for you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace to us all. Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those called now to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. Let us pray. May the working of your power, O Lord, increase in us, we pray, so that, renewed by these heavenly sacraments, we may be prepared by your gift for the receiving of what they promise through Christ our Lord. Thank you so much, everyone, for celebrating this Mass with us today here at Our Lady of Las Vegas Church. I thank all of our ministers, as always, Julia for being our lector and Mikhail for managing our cameras, and for Eva and Dave for lifting us up in music at this liturgy. You know, we are in the month of November now, as I said at the beginning, and this is the month that traditionally we pray for the repose of the souls of the faithful departed, those in purgatory, which is still a belief of the Church. Purgatory, of course, is that stage of a soul's time after death that it's prepared to meet God personally, face to face. And so a soul must be perfectly purged of all attachment to sin and all that still remains attached to that soul, so that it can stand pure in the sight of God. And that's why we pray for the souls in purgatory. It's a time for them that they realize that they are on their journey toward God, and through our prayers we can hasten that journey for them. So remember to pray for them, especially now during this month of November. Here at Our Lady of Las Vegas Church, we're having a series of Masses, a novena of Masses, nine Masses for 9 days in a row for the souls of the faithful departed. And so please remember to pray for them. If you are celebrating a birthday or anniversary or something special going on in your life today or this week, our best wishes to you. And if you are carrying a heavy burden or heavy load, please know that our prayers go with you as well. This coming Thursday on November 7th at 6 p.m., we are having a Mass of Remembrance here at Our Lady. So if you are in the area, we invite you to come. All those who have passed away this past year, and had their funeral Masses here at Our Lady, we will have a special Mass remembering them and honoring them, praying for them, this coming Thursday, November 7th at 6 o'clock here in our church. So if you are around, please come and join us. And so now, as we go forth, let us do so humbly and with God's blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is now ended. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
Kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed.